But in the midst of instability, my faith grew, amen? My capacity to believe God grew and became stronger. And we have an amazing church in Montreal. I can't wait for each one of you to see it. In those 3 years, God have enlarged my heart to love, enlarged my heart to give, enlarged my heart to be able to serve, amen? God brought me to a place of humility where I have to start from zero. Hello, I would like to thank Papa Usu, Dr. Usu, for having been hospitable to me and to my little church in the beginning. It wasn't easy leaving this beautiful place, the comfort, the love of my people, to start from zero. Seriously. Hello? It wasn't easy. Thank you so much for having us in the 3 years, for allowing us to rent this place. So, God is good. I say God is good. And all the time. And you know I'm coming back. And because I'm coming back a different person. I'm coming back to a different church. I believe 3 years you have changed. You have moved. Amen. But get ready for more. I say get ready for more. Are you ready for more? Are you flexible? Are you flexible? Are you willing to go with the wind of the Spirit? Hallelujah. We're going to let God be God, and we're going to just move with the wind. Amen. May God bless you. I'm happy to be in the house. I'd like to thank Eve for the amazing job he's done. He's still serving in the house of God. He's one of my strongest leaders. When I left, he said something to me. He said, you know, publicly said, Pastor, this is your baby. And we're going to take care of it. And I know you will do it, Eve, with the team. Amen. So now we have Cross Point Fellowship, Cross Point Nouvel Espoir. Amen. Are you ready for your heart to be enlarged even more? I love you guys so, so, so much. And for those, thank you so much. Thank you. For those who I haven't met this afternoon, I'm so glad we have a barbecue so we'll be able to visit and get to know one another even more. And I'm going to get to reintroduce myself. Amen. Because after 3 years in the wilderness, you become a different person. Amen. God is good. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, somebody. I'm going to ask those in the back, stand up on your feet as well. Unless if you're lame, we will pray for you so you can walk. This is a time of honor. And we honor by standing, not by sitting. Praise the Lord, somebody. You know, she's just speaking word, but only God knows the depths of it. No word can explain. I'm a witness of what God has done through this woman. I came there, there were so many few people, I almost depressed. I doubted. I said, what the heck did I just did? Leaving my wife to come here in this wilderness? How can that be? But she made me a believer. Every time I come to visit, they were excited when I was depressed because I felt, what the heck are they exciting about? This church is empty. But today, you know what? The church has grown. They have many baptismal candidates. Membership have increased. People have grown spiritually. People have grown mentally, emotionally. Their life have been transformed. I'm just witnessing. I'm speaking of what I've seen with my own eyes. And we want to say it as a body on the behalf of the leadership and this wonderful church that you stand here. We are proud of you. Because as it was said, you have opened a way for each one of these mighty people to know that it's possible. You've done it. You opened the way. Nothing is therefore impossible for Crosspoint people. If Mama did it, by the same grace it has been bestowed upon you, you can do it and it can do much more. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. On the behalf of the leadership and the church, we want to give you these beautiful flowers. Baby, receive those. You deserve it. All the way. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Follow up and be proud of me too. I am so proud of me. Amen. I need a picture. I need a nice picture.
We are proud of her. Am I right? Are we proud of her? Hallelujah. And I would like to present you with this from an apostolic perspective. This is a special award and once of its kind. Because you went and you did a tremendous work planting a phenomenal headquarter in the east side. It's written Church Planter Award. Cross Point Church Planter Award. Hallelujah, somebody. Church Planter Award presented to this one. I owe it to Pastor Joseph. Mama G.O. Mama G.O. Mama G.O. Pastor Nadia, Canada East Headquarters, mission accomplished. This is for you, baby. Congratulations. Thank you so much. God bless you. We love you and we are looking forward to hear more about you. But church, get ready. She's not the same you know. She's expanded and more dangerous. Hallelujah. Can we give a clap offering to the Lord? Hallelujah. Hey. Thank you, Father. Sunday, we're going to have a Holy Ghost service in this house. Let just be normal today. Let not be normal today. I would like we celebrate the life of our resident sons and daughter, Pastor John Baptist and Jenny, for the amazing work. Come on, church. Let's give it to them. God bless you. Next Sunday, we'll have much to say. Thank you. You may have a seat all in the presence of the Lord. Today is Canada Day. And you understand this country has been grounded and founded upon the word of the Lord. It's not a pagan country. This is a country that was founded on the word of the Lord. The founder of these great nations were moved by the Holy Spirit to establish the stones by inspiration from God. It might look like today Canada is shifting away from that heritage, but I'm going to tell you, the last portion of the history of this country has not been written yet. I will say it again. The last portion of the history of this country has not been written. So do not be dismayed. Where we begin and the founders begin, our forefathers begin, we are going back there again. Because when lawlessness increases in the earth, God's goodness and his grace will increase even more. Praise the Lord. And therefore, I would like we stand up, I would like we sing the national anthem. If I can get Bethia to help us, for all of you immigrants who have not learned it yet. I'm going to look at your mouth and see if you're singing or you're miming. Everybody put your hand on your right heart. This is our country. We're standing on guard for thee, Canada. Thank you for this wonderful land that you have given unto us. Thank you for the men and the women who stand to guard this country. Even those who are in the field, in the different countries, laying their lives at front lines, for the safety of this country, for the peace in this country. We bless them, and we bless Canada, that Canada may continue to prosper. Canada may kept going higher. In the standing of the nation, let the voice of Canada be heard. In Jesus' name, amen. Don't leave. We'd like to stay with us. Stay with us, officers. Of course, Constable Espinoza will share a word. Brother, I love you. It's so good to see you again. I remember our time together having coffee at the Tim Hortons. And now here we are. I want you to come closer. So we've been watched across the world. So we want you to see you. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for keeping our community safe. Hallelujah. I would just like to give a small story. How my life has changed and the way I see the police forces. About 6 weeks, 2 months about, I was with my son. My son is autistic. I was with him in Kenmore, in the hotel, swimming because he liked water. So I like to take him some time outside in the mountains. He actually came with me, you know, we booked the hotel and all this stuff, and we drove back. I had to put everything in place before I bring him. So I will go to Kenmore, prepare everything, come and pick him up, and we go. And that day we went swimming and came back in the room. As I was changing, suddenly he opened the door and he just escaped. He is very fast. I think he is the fastest person, more even faster than Bolt. Usain Bolt can catch up my son. My son is another level of speed. And he was gone. I stepped out. I didn't know where my son was. And he was naked. He has removed his trunk. He is a boy of 15 turning 16. So past puberty, he's a man. No clothes, nothing. Naked. And he ran out. I pulled out the doors, run different corner. I didn't know where he was. Finally, I raced to the counter. So amazing. I have told them I have my son who's autistic just to get an awareness. Oh, is it your son? He was naked. He just walked out of the door. Just as simple as can say, what? You saw a boy of 16 almost walking out of the door and you think it's normal and he's all naked. And I stepped out. I didn't know where my son was. For 25 minutes, I turned around hotels to the street. Of course, the highway is on this side. It was some of the most stressful moments for me. I was in my swimming trunk and a towel. After 25 minutes, I was about to call 911. And of course, I saw him on the corner, just not far from the highway. And I couldn't chase because he would think it's a joke and just run across the highway. So I'm just talking to him, and he's running on the side road thinking it's a joke. Make the story short, he stopped, and I grabbed him and put the towel around him. I brought him to the hotel. I was so messed up. Let me put it that way. I packed all my stuff. I still had 2 nights to stay at the hotel. I just refused to stay there. I didn't talk to anybody. I was in tears, of course, overwhelmed. I jumped in the car, heading to Calgary, and the pedal was a little bit too heavy. My foot was too heavy on the pedal. As I was cruising through Trans-Canada, I couldn't wait to get out of that place. And of course, the patrol of the highway just pulled out from behind me with the lights on. I said, oh my God, I'm in tears. I'm cleaning up my tears because I don't want him to see me cry. And then he came in. You know, you were speaking. I said, sure, I was. Right? I can't lie. I'm a pastor. You know what I'm saying? So he pulled out my stuff, bring me a ticket. And when he was coming, I didn't realize my son was still sitting on my side and he had not put his belt on. He was in all states, you can imagine. I was in tears, under moved by what happened, my son running naked in the street. I mean, it was too much. And of course, he noticed that I was very overwhelmed. And I tell you, people, the police is not here for our bad. I've seen it, and I'm testifying of it. He was moved. And he saw me talking to my son with sign languages. So he realized my son was not doing okay. So he brought some toys, some badges and stuff like that. He doesn't understand much of that language. So he came back and said, you know what? Leave the tickets alone. I will just dissolve it. And so I told him, no. I know I was speeding, so I want to pay for the ticket. That's just the way it is. I abide by the laws of the land. And he insisted. And finally, I kept it. He said, okay, anyway, I'm going to do it on my screen. You don't need to go pay. And he came and he said, listen, park here. I will stand behind you until it cools down. And if you want, I can actually usher you in until you feel safe. I was so moved. Brothers and sisters, that's the police. That is the law agent, the enforcers of the law, the workers for you and I, our community. That's just, I want to just say thank you to you and every other one who's putting their life on the line and serving us. You know, that day, I left and I know God just ministered to me using a police agent, a patrol agent to minister to me. I felt loved. I felt protected. I felt secure. And I was bold. I wiped my tears. And I feel like, yes, God, you haven't turned your face away from me. You are still with me. And my son cooled down and we made it safe at home. So again, God bless you. It was one of yours. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
I don't know where to start. First of all, he chose Tim Hortons. I didn't. I'm a little embarrassed when I go to Timmy's. I'm a little embarrassed when I go to Timmy's because they don't charge me. And I don't want people to see me getting my coffee for free. And this is nothing short of humbling. Everything that's going on here today. You brought me here when it was just a shell of a building.
Yes.
Yeah. It's amazing what you've done in this place. And I notice why you've been avoiding me. All the work going on elsewhere. Okay, good. Good. So my name is Constable Raul Espinoza. For the Latin Americans in the audience, if there's any in the congregation. You guys are familiar with that. It's not Smith, it's not McDonald, it's not, it's Espinoza. I was born in South America. I was born down in Colombia, just like Carlos here, yeah. I've been a police officer for just about 18 years. I'm approaching 12 years with the Calgary Police Service. I started my career elsewhere. That's who I am. I am also the liaison for the African, Latin American, Caribbean communities with our diversity resources team. What I do, I build relationships. That's my job. Drink a lot of coffee, yes. But that's who I am and what I do. Most importantly is why. Why it is that I do this? And you pastors have a way of saying things like judges and lawyers. At times we don't understand sometimes what you say. Explain a little bit more sometimes. Yeah. Here's why I say that. I was born and I grew up Baptist, in the Baptist faith. Despite the fact I'm a bit of a backslider right now, I see why you put that lamp right there. I think I don't know that. I'm going to step out this way so it doesn't follow me. No joke. Joke aside. Growing up in the Baptist faith, the pastor always talk about find your calling. Find your calling. But never explained too much about it. Until about 30 years later. Yeah. Even when I started being a police officer back down in the Caribbean, just something that caught my attention. I started doing it. But it wasn't until I came here and later on had the opportunity to liaise with community members, immigrants just like me, that I understood what my calling was. And it's what I love to do. It's what I'm doing. It's what these guys do every day. In support of that, I am humbled. I'm so humbled. I wanted to bring more more of my colleagues, brothers and sisters here today. The way things happened, they weren't able to be here. But I'm going to take this back, definitely take this back and help them understand how much we're appreciated. It's not something we hear every day. I don't really need to hear it. It's just I do it out of my heart, what I do. But thank you very much for saying it, and thank you very much for recognizing that. I'm very humbled. Thank you.
God bless you all. We'd like to pray for you. And of course, we have our own Pastor Kofi that's a part of the team. And we have also our own Jeff Cope, who serves with the Canadian Army Air Force. Hold hand together as the bond of unity. Is that's what you guys do to make us safe as you work together. Church, stretch your hand toward these men and women who have families, but God has called them to be his representative. As Romans chapter 13 said, verse 1, all authority comes from God. These are the agents of God. These are the men and women God have chosen. And Father, we bless them for their heart of sacrifice. We bless their families. We bless their children. Father God, you said, unless the Lord keep the city, those who guard it in vain. And Father, we thank you for the release of angelical reinforcement in their day-to-day duties on the front line, serving the community for the welfare and to establish peace. Lord, we bless them. You know they need. You know where they need a breakthrough. We know you know where they need an uplifting. Will you on this Sunday, as we celebrate you for Canada and we celebrate the law enforcement agent, will you lift them up and reward them with your presence? Father God, satisfy them in all things and make their joy complete. Protect their lives in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We love you. We appreciate you. We celebrate you. Come on, church, put it on. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, somebody. Jesus is Lord of Canada. Thank God for law enforcement. Hallelujah. Yeah. We have seen the presence of the Lord. Of course, we're going to have the barbecue. It will be a great time to mingle around with this law enforcement. So we don't fear them in a way that they are against us. They are for us. They are our friends. They are our protectors. They are here for our care. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody. I would like to call Bishop Michelle. We're talking about Latin America. She was on fire. And of course, she is going Monday, tomorrow, to Nicaragua to do the work of the Lord. Amen. And Pastor Michelle, Bishop Michelle, I don't want to bring it down. We are so proud of you. I know your heart for Latino country. This is just amazing. Do we have some Latino people here? Thank you, Lord. Pastor Orlando, God bless you. We want to let you know that you are going. And I know you waited for this time for so long. But God does make all things beautiful in their season. There could not have been a better time than this. Tomorrow was what heaven had set up for you to step out in this next level of your calling. We have no doubt of what God is going to do for you, because we know what you carry and what God has embedded in you. You just go in the freedom of the Holy Ghost. You just go with the boldness of the Holy Ghost, and you go in the authority that Christ has given unto us in the earth and in the heavens. Nothing will stand your core. Allow God to flow through you without limits. Allow him to expand your capacity. Don't restrict yourself. Just be you. Yes. And do what you do best. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's stand up as we reach our hand toward this mighty lady. Father, in the name of Jesus, you have chosen this time to send Bishop Michelle. We thank you first for her life, for her devotion for you, for the passion she has for the field, You have raised her up for such a time as this. Father, by the authority that you have given to me in the name of Jesus, I release her with power. I release her with boldness. I release her with authority. Thank you for the angels that encompass around her. Thank you for those who open the way before her. Enrich her heart with word that will bring healing. Enrich her heart with word that will bring comfort. Enrich her heart with word that will bring the lonely and the rejected, the broken, to dare to believe and to hope again. Let her be the carrier of hope to everyone that she will meet on her way. Father, thank you. I bless her with wisdom. Wisdom to tear down and wisdom to build. Wisdom to recalibrate and wisdom to stand and speak forth what is right. Lord, we just put her into your hands. As for her and her family, look after them in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Let's have a seat. I'm going to now call our dear friends for the short word and a couple of worships, and we're going to go and have our barbecue, because I think the service today, fellowship is a full part of it. And we don't want to take away from fellowship. We really want to enjoy this time and enjoy one another. And I'm sure Mama here, she can't wait to hug every one of you, because this is a time to bond again, hugging one another, talking and sharing with one another. That's the church. Amen. This man that is coming to share the word with us, when you released them, when they were released to go to Montreal, he welcomed them. For those who have already been there, or the video that you've seen, that's his church. In other words, we are renting from him. He has hosted us in his beautiful, amazing building. This is a man who is a great teacher of the Word of God, who have established a great ministry in the city of Montreal, and that's not an easy work. He is by trade a professor in economic and finances. That's what he have done until God called him. He taught in university in Africa, and he taught also at the University of Montreal for a few years before God called him to start the church. He is a man who has a big heart of love and compassion, and we have eaten of the fruit of that heart. Married to one wife that is a great intercessor. He had two biological children and many, many, many sons and daughters in the ministry. Papa Usu, on the behalf of the house, we just want to say thank you, because you have hosted us. You made us feel at home. God have chosen you to give a place to Mama so that she can start what God has embedded in her heart so deeply for so many years. And under your roof, it has become a reality. And therefore, we want to bless you. We want to thank you. We want to celebrate you. And we want to honor you. Church, let's stand up as I call forth Dr. Usu to come and share the word with us. Thank you. Feel free, you are home.
Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. Que Dieu vous bénisse.
May the Lord bless you richly.
J'aimerais dire juste un mot rapidement.
Quick word.
Quelle grâce d'être dans cette belle place.
What a grace that is in this beautiful place.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Je suis vraiment béni d'être parmi vous ce matin.
I am so blessed to be among you this morning.
Je me sens comme à la maison.
I feel home.
Et voilà pourquoi je vous ai accueilli à Montréal.
And that's why I have welcomed you to Montreal.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen, amen.
Maman Nadia.
Maman Nadia.
ACPVM will miss you.
Our church will miss you dearly.
Personally, I will miss you so much.
Personnellement, tu vas nous manquer beaucoup.
Est-ce qu'on peut acclamer le Seigneur?
Can we give a clap offering
S'il vous
to the
plaît,
Lord?
Pour Maman Nadia.
Give him a clap offering.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Alors, j'aimerais dire un secret.
I would like to reveal to you a secret.
Vous savez, les hommes dans l'armée le savent bien. Les hommes de rang.
Those who are in rank and in the enforcement law
knows this. Ils vont le témoigner.
And they will testify what I'm going to say.
Vous savez, lorsque vous envoyez vos forces combattre,
when you release your forces to go fight at the front line,
à un certain moment donné, ces forces sont fatiguées.
And at a given time, sometimes they get tired.
Et alors, l'Éternel des armées, le Dieu tout-puissant.
And therefore, God in heavens.
Il a compris que c'était le moment parce que nous, on a travaillé pendant 22 ans là-bas. On était un peu essoufflé.
You know, we worked there 22, 23 years in Montreal. Sometimes we get really tired, and therefore, as we send people at the front line, they get tired. And God in heaven understood.
Et Dieu va envoyer apôtre Diallo et maman Nadia et Cross Point pour nous rafraîchir.
And
hallelujah.
Before we are the front line, we are tired. Chose Apostle and Pastor Nadia as a reinforcement to come and help us there in Montreal.
Donc vous avez été pour nous une bénédiction.
You have been a blessing to us.
Que Dieu vous bénisse.
May the Lord bless you.
Mama Nadia, tu vas me manquer beaucoup.
Mama Nadia, I will miss you much.
Que Dieu vous bénisse.
May the Lord bless you. You can have a seat in the presence of the Lord.
Gloire à l'agneau. Alors ce matin nous irons très très rapidement.
This morning we will run a little quicker.
Parce que c'est une grande célébration.
Hallelujah.
Because
we have a great celebration this
morning.
Gloire
à Dieu, nous irons tout droit au but. Nous allons ouvrir nos Bibles dans le livre d'Ésaïe.
We're going to go to Isaiah right away in the Bible, Isaiah.
Mais avant cela, j'aimerais vous transmettre les salutations de Montréal.
And I just before that I want to greet you on the behalf of Montreal.
Et de tout le Québec.
And the whole province of
Hallelujah.
Quebec.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Vive le Canada.
Viva Canada.
Amen. Alors nous ouvrons donc nos Bibles dans Ésaïe 43 verset 10.
Isaiah 43 verse 10. 43 verse 10 Isaiah.
Et nous lisons très très rapidement.
And we'll read quickly.
Le Seigneur déclare ici, vous êtes mes témoins, dit l'Éternel.
You are my witnesses, says the Lord.
Vous et mon serviteur que j'ai choisi.
And my servant whom I have chosen.
Afin que vous sachiez.
That you may know.
Que vous me croyez et compreniez que c'est moi.
And believe me and understand that I am he.
Avant moi, il n'y a point été formé de Dieu.
Before me, there was no God formed.
Et après moi, il n'y en aura point.
And after me, there will be none.
C'est moi, moi qui suis l'Éternel.
Verse 11, please.
Oui, le verset
11. I and even I am the Lord.
Et hors de moi, il n'y a point de sauveur.
And beside me, there is no savior.
Verset suivant.
The next verse.
C'est moi qui ai annoncé, sauvé et prédit.
I have declared and saved and have proclaimed.
Ce n'est point parmi vous un Dieu étranger.
And there was no foreign God among you.
Vous êtes mes témoins, dit l'Éternel.
Therefore, you are my witnesses, says the Lord, that I am God.
Yes, c'est moi qui suis Dieu.
I am God.
Et le verset 13 nous dit ceci.
Verse 13
je
says,
le suis dès le commencement.
Indeed, before the day was.
Nul ne délivre de ma main.
I was he, and there is no one that can deliver out of my hand.
J'agirai.
I work.
Qui s'y opposera?
And who will reverse it?
Amen, amen.
Amen.
Pendant ce week-end, nous avons vu qu'il était important pour les enfants de Dieu.
During this weekend, we have learned that it was very important
pour un leader spirituel de se redéfinir.
As a spiritual leader to redefine yourself.
Mais nous voyons ici le Seigneur lui-même qui se redéfinit à son peuple.
And God here is redefining himself to his people through this portion of scripture.
C'est une bonne pratique que chaque matin tu te réveilles et que tu te rappelles qui tu es en Christ.
And it's become important that every morning you wake up, you need to remind yourself of who you are in Christ.
Les animaux n'en ont pas besoin.
Animals don't need that.
Lorsque l'aigle se réveille chaque matin,
every time the eagle awakens in the morning,
il sait que Dieu lui a donné des ailes pour s'envoler
très haut. Eagle knows that God has given him wings to fly high.
Il n'a pas peur de la tempête, non.
And therefore, if the eagle does not fear the tempest.
Parce que en permanence, il sait qu'il est un aigle.
Why? Because he knows that he is an eagle.
Il sait qu'il n'est pas un poulet.
He knows that he's not a chicken, but an eagle.
Amen.
Amen.
Et lorsque la tempête va se déclencher,
and when tempests come forth,
Il va étendre ses ailes.
The eagle just stretch out his wings.
Et affronter la tempête.
And will go through the tempest.
Et utiliser toute cette énergie de la tempête pour s'envoler encore beaucoup plus haut que la tempête.
And will use even the tempest opposition and adversity to go further.
L'aigle ne réfléchit pas, il sait qu'il est un aigle.
And though, therefore the eagle does not think. The eagle knows that he's an eagle.
Mais pour nous les hommes, c'est pas la même chose, nous réfléchissons.
But for us human beings, we have to think.
Et lorsque nous sommes oppressés,
and therefore when we face adversity,
lorsque nous sommes sous un gros stress,
when we are pressed down under stress,
nous avons besoin de nous redéfinir.
And therefore we have to redefine ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Et Dieu nous rappelle ici qu'il est Dieu.
And therefore God is reminding us in this portion of scripture that he is God.
C'est un rappel technique.
It is a technical reminder.
Pour que nous ne nous défocussions pas, pour que nous soyons toujours focusés.
So that we do not walk away from the course, but we remain focused.
Sur les buts de Dieu sur cette terre.
Focus on the goals and the purpose of God
il
in
nous
the
a
earth.
Choisi.
Because he has chosen us.
Il nous a établi.
He has established
il nous
us.
A dit d'aller et faire son œuvre.
And he has given us a commandment to go and do his will.
Donc Dieu me rappelle ici qu'il est Dieu.
And therefore, in this portion of scripture, God Alleluia. Is reminding us that he is God.
Il est l'alpha et il est l'oméga.
He is the alpha and he is the omega.
Et je dois m'en rappeler tout le temps.
And I have to remind myself of
le
such.
Le matin, je me lève, je dis, mon Dieu est l'alpha et l'oméga.
So when I wake up in the morning, I declare, my God is the alpha and he is the omega.
Quel que soit le stress, no je matter, sais que mon Dieu est sur le trône.
No matter what I'm facing, I am convinced that my God is on the throne.
Mon Dieu est sur le trône.
My God is in the throne.
Que la situation soit difficile.
No matter what the size of the adversity
Mon Dieu est l'alpha et l'oméga.
It does not change this truth. My God is the Alpha and He is the Omega. Hallelujah. Somebody give a hand to the Lord.
Hallelujah. Alors, ça renouvelle ma foi.
And knowing that, it renewed my faith.
Ça, c'est une redéfinition technique.
That's what I'm talking about, a technical redefinition.
J'en ai besoin.
Why? Because I need it.
Et c'est urgent.
And it's an urgent need.
Hallelujah.
I need it. Thank you.
Donc, ça, c'est pour juste comprendre que j'ai besoin d'avoir une relation privilégiée avec Dieu.
And that means you and I, we need to have a privileged relationship with God.
Ça renouvelle ma foi continuellement.
Knowing that it renews my faith continually.
Et je m'appuie sur Dieu.
And therefore I can lean on God.
Pour me redéfinir.
I lean on God to redefine myself.
Il nous demande de regarder d'où nous avons été taillés.
And therefore he speaks to us to turn back and see where he has hewn us out of.
Car c'est là la source même de ma définition.
From that rock you were hewn out, that is the source of your original connection.
Je ne dois pas me détacher de ma source.
And therefore you do not disconnect from the source.
Et alors l'onction sera renouvelée et restaurée.
When you connect to the source, your anointing will always be renewed and restored.
Et je pourrai m'appuyer sur Dieu à chaque instant.
Then and only then I can lean on him in any situation.
Parce qu'il dit qu'il agira, qui s'y opposera?
Why? Because he tells us, I will act and who can reverse it?
Qui s'y opposera? Personne.
Who can reverse my doings?
Il demeure à jamais Dieu.
And therefore he remains God forever.
Et il délivre sans le recours de personne.
And therefore he delivers without the need of a hand of man.
Je te déclare que Dieu te délivre sans le recours de personne.
And I declare unto you, God will deliver you without the help of man.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Bien-aimés, en tant qu'enfants de Dieu, nous avons besoin d'une jurisprudence solide.
Beloved, as sons and daughters of God, we need a true insurance in our life.
Pour fixer le surnaturel. Dans Ésaïe 43, verset 25, il dit ceci.
Chapter 23, verse 45.
C'est moi qui efface tes transgressions. Pour l'amour de moi.
He said, it is me who erase your transgression for the love of myself, for my name's sake.
Et je ne me souviendrai plus de tes péchés.
And therefore, I will no longer remember your sins.
Verset 26.
Verse 26 said,
réveille ma mémoire.
And he said, awaken me, awaken my memory.
Plaidons ensemble.
And let's plead together.
Parle toi-même pour te justifier.
And you not to justify yourself.
Cela veut dire qu'il y a des moments où j'ai besoin de bouger la main de Dieu par ma propre justification.
In other words, there is time where I have to move the hand of God by my own justification.
Je dois dire à Dieu, Ta main doit bouger maintenant.
I have to say to God, Lord, now your hand has to move.
J'en ai besoin maintenant
pour demain. I need it now, now.
Et Dieu va te dire, ah bon?
And God will say, oh yeah?
Explique-moi pourquoi.
Please, you need to explain. Why do you need my hand to move?
Ta jurisprudence doit être solide.
And therefore, you need to know who you are in God based on your relationship.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Dieu veut savoir pourquoi sa main doit bouger.
God now want to know, why do you want my hand to move?
Il y a des situations dans nos vies, dans nos familles et dans nos ministères où nous avons besoin parfois de façon urgente.
There
de voir la main de Dieu bouger.
There is places in our lives, in our families, in our churches and ministries where we need the hand of God to move now.
Et alors, il va falloir que je plaide comme un bon avocat.
And therefore, I have to plead like a good lawyer.
Je plaide pour ma propre cause.
Because I am pleading for my own cause.
Je plaide pour mon peuple.
I am pleading for my people.
Je plaide pour ma famille.
I am pleading for my family.
Je plaide pour tout le pays.
And I'm pleading for the country.
Parce que je veux que la main de Dieu.
Why? Because I want God's hand to move.
Et Dieu veut que ma jurisprudence soit très solide.
And therefore God wants you to stand strong on his word.
Il veut que mes arguments soient puissants.
He wants your argument based on the word up. Being powerful.
Voilà comment nous sommes ouvriers avec Dieu.
And that's the way we become co-workers, co-laborers with God.
Il y a des demandes qui viennent du ciel.
There are demonic powers that come from above.
Non, il y a des demandes qui viennent du ciel.
There are some demands that are released from heaven.
Dieu nous demande de les accomplir.
And God wants us to fulfill the demands of heaven on the earth.
Et nous nous soumettons.
And therefore we surrender to such demands.
Il y a aussi des demandes qui peuvent venir de la terre.
There are also demands that come from the earth.
Nous sommes ouvriers avec Dieu.
That's why we are working together
Dieu
with God.
Dieu est notre partenaire.
God is your partner.
Comme la police et l'armée sont nos partenaires.
The same way the police force are our
Est-ce
partners.
Est-ce qu'on peut acclamer le Seigneur?
Can we give a
Dieu
clap offering
est
to
ton
Lord?
Partenaire.
God is your partner.
Dieu est de ton côté.
God is on your side.
Mais il veut pas faire n'importe quoi.
And he will not do anything.
Il veut que tu lui expliques exactement pourquoi je dois
he
le faire.
He wants you to give him guidance why he has to move his hand.
Parce que quand il va le faire, il va le faire.
Because when God decides to do something, he does it.
Parce que toi, tu as fait une demande.
You put a demand on heaven.
Et Dieu glorifie son nom en accomplissant
God
ce que toi,
Dieu. God will glorify his name by fulfilling
Est-ce
your demand.
Est-ce qu'on peut acclamer le Seigneur?
Can we give a clap offering to the Lord?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
La Bible nous montre grandement que Daniel a plaidé pour son peuple.
The Bible said that Daniel pleaded for his people.
Moïse a plaidé pour son peuple.
Moses pleaded for his people.
David a plaidé.
David pleaded.
Et chaque fois qu'il plaidait, la main de Dieu se déployait.
And every time one of these one pleaded the cause of his people, the hand of God
moved. Et la puissance de Dieu se manifestait.
And the power of God was released.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bien-aimés, nous avons besoin d'une atmosphère de miracle et de puissance et
we
de
have, we need an atmosphere of miracle and wonders.
Dans les temps difficiles.
In those difficult times.
Et nous irons très très brièvement dans Ésaïe 38. Vous connaissez ce passage.
And we'll read in Isaiah chapter 30, verse 8.
Le verset 1.
Ah, 38.
Ésaïe 38, verset 1.
Yeah. Isaiah 38, verse 1.
Nous allons lire Isaiah les 5 1. Premiers versets
we'll
lead
the
en
five
vitesse.
First verses
en vitesse et
sprinting.
On va terminer.
Sprinting and we'll finish.
La Bible dit ceci. En ce temps-là, Ézéchias fut malade à la mort.
In those days, Ezekiah was sick and near to death.
Le prophète Ésaïe, fils d'Amos, vint auprès de lui et lui dit.
And Isaiah, the prophet, the son of Amos, went to him and said to him.
Ainsi parle l'Éternel, donne des ordres à ta maison, car tu vas mourir.
That says the Lord, set your house in order, for you shall die and not live.
Et tu ne vivras plus.
And you will not live.
Ézéchias tourna son visage contre le mur et fit cette prière
then,
à l'Éternel.
Then Ezekiah turned his face toward the wall and prayed to the Lord.
Oh Éternel, souviens-toi que j'ai marché devant ta face avec fidélité et intégrité de cœur et que j'ai fait ce qui est bien à tes yeux.
And said, remember now, O Lord, I pray, how I have walked before you in truth. I have walked before you in truth and with a loyal heart. And have done what is good in your sight. And Ezekiah wept bitterly.
Amen. Donc Ézéchias répandit d'abondantes larmes. Puis la parole de l'Éternel fut adressée à Isaïe en ces termes.
And the word of the Lord came to Isaiah saying, and Ezekiah wept and cried bitterly.
Alors, et, donc l'Éternel va maintenant parler à Isaïe et va lui dire ceci. Va et dis à Ézéchias, ainsi parle l'Éternel, le Dieu de David, ton père.
Go and tell Ezekiah, that says the Lord, and go of David, your father.
J'ai entendu ta prière et j'ai vu tes larmes. Voici, j'ajouterai à tes années 15 années.
I have heard your prayers and I have seen your tears. Surely I will add to your days 15 years.
Amen.
Amen.
Alors, nous voyons ici le roi Ézéchias qui se trouve dans une situation plus que difficile.
We see here Ezekiah, the king, in a very difficult situation.
Mais nous avons vu que cet homme avait beaucoup de crédit dans son compte au ciel.
And of course, we know this man was a great man. He had a lot of credits in heaven.
Dans la banque de l'intégrité et de la fidélité, son compte était rempli.
In the bank of integrity and faithfulness, he was at the top.
Nous devons marcher dans la fidélité et dans l'intégrité
avec
notre
Dieu. We have to walk in faithfulness and integrity with the Lord.
Parce qu'en faisant cela, nous sommes en train de remplir notre compte au ciel.
When we do so, we are depositing good things in our account in heaven.
Nous avons vu que lorsque nous sommes en train de prier, eh bien, ce sont des parfums que nous sommes en train de déverser dans des coupes d'or au ciel.
Whenever we pray, we are releasing incense in heaven in the golden pot in the hand of the angels.
Et nous comprenons que ça, c'est des demandes qui descendent d'en haut.
And we understand those are demands that have been released from above.
Et nous le faisons.
And we achieve or we obey.
Et grâce à ce parfum, and les anges se déploient et activent de grandes choses sur cette terre.
And because of the incense, the prayers of the saints, it releases the angels to manifest and to do great things in the
hallelujah.
Earth.
Hallelujah. Est-ce qu'on peut acclamer notre Dieu?
Can we give a clap offering to the Lord?
Acclamons notre Dieu très fort. Hallelujah. Oh, gloire à Dieu. Alors, Ézéchias se trouve dans une situation difficile parce que Dieu dit, écoute, Ézéchias, tu vas mourir. Le temps que je t'ai réservé sur la terre est terminé.
Here is the situation Ezekiah, the king, is facing. God said, Ezekiah, your time on earth is over. You are going to die.
Je suis le Dieu des temps et des circonstances.
Because I am the God of seasons and times.
Je t'ai donné un temps sur terre.
I gave you a specific located time on the earth.
Terminé.
It is over.
Prépare-toi.
And therefore, prepare yourself.
Quel privilège, hallelujah.
It's a privilege.
Parce que Dieu lui révèle qu'il va mourir.
Because God is telling this man you are going to die.
Dieu lui a dit, écoute, voici, et Dieu n'a pas parlé en l'air. Il a parlé au travers du prophète Isaïe.
God spoke through the prophet Isaiah to tell Ezekiah you are about to die.
Nous connaissons Isaïe.
We know Isaiah.
Quand il parle, eh bien, c'est une lame qui a tranché.
You know, when Isaiah is speaking, it's like a light.
Hallelujah. Mm. Alors, qu'est-ce qui va se passer?
What is going to happen now?
Esaïe va dire à Ézéchias, écoute, Dieu me commande de te dire que c'est terminé, tu vas mourir.
And therefore, Isaiah brought forth the message to tell to Ezekiah, God said, your days are over.
Ézéchias se dit, quoi?
And as Ezekiah goes, what?
J'ai du crédit dans mon compte au ciel.
I have credits in heaven, you know.
J'irai directement parler à Dieu.
And I will go straight to my God and speak to him.
Et la Bible déclare qu'il va faire une prière assez courte.
And the Bible says he turned his face to the wall and pray.
Une brève prière mais puissante.
A very short yet powerful prayer.
Il va rappeler des choses à Dieu.
He is going to remind God of certain things.
Ça c'est une jurisprudence. Il va dire, écoute Seigneur, il y a des choses qui se sont passées. Et je sais que tu agiras sur la base de ce qui s'est passé.
In other words, he stood back on what was so faithful and true in his life. He telling God, I have done these things for you. He has a ground to stand on.
Et la Bible dit qu'il a pleuré.
The Bible says he wept.
Il a dit, Seigneur, je refuse ce décret-là.
And he said, Lord, I disagree with this decree.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Il dit non à Dieu.
He said, God, no.
Il dit, maintenant, Seigneur, ta main doit se déployer pour arrêter
he
la
said,
mort.
No, now at this time, Lord, your hand has to move to put an end to the death.
Tu as dit à l'ange de la mort de venir me chercher.
You told the angel of death to come and take me up.
Toi-même reparle à l'ange de la mort qu'il retourne d'où il vient.
Will you command the angel of death to go back to where he come from?
Il a fait une courte prière.
He prayed short.
Et Dieu regarde son crédit.
And God look at his credit, his account in heaven.
Il voit que sa banque est remplie.
And his account was on the top.
Pendant qu'Ézéchias, le prophète, était encore dans la cour du roi.
As Isaiah was still in the court of the king after bringing the message, he has not left yet. He was still in the
il
court.
Il était encore là en train éventuellement de boire un peu d'eau.
He was probably there hanging around having a cup of water.
Dieu lui dit, hey, oh, arrête de boire, dépêche-toi, va voir mon serviteur.
God said, hold it, Isaiah. Stop doing what you're doing. Go back to speak to the
retourne
king.
Retourne voir Ézéchias et dis-lui qu'il ne va plus mourir.
Go back and tell Ezekiah I change things here, you will not die.
Je pense que Isaïe s'est dit, mais attends, quel est l'esprit qui me parle?
The prophet Isaiah was going, what the heck is going on?
Attends,
what is the
spirit? Attends, est-ce que je me trompe ou quoi?
Am I messing up my mind?
Non, non, Dieu dit, non, c'est moi qui te parle.
Is it another spirit?
Retourne, dépêche-toi.
It's me, it's not another spirit. I'm Ezekias the one who's telling you to go back.
Ezekias n'est pas n'importe qui.
Ezekiah is just a great man, he's just not anybody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Il dit quoi?
Say what?
Ezekias n'est pas n'importe qui.
Ezekiah is not just a normal guy.
Donc je dois maintenant changer la parole que tu m'as donnée pour lui. Dieu dit oui.
Isaiah now said, am I going to go back to reverse the word that I've given to him at first? And then God said, yeah, you need to go back and do so.
Oh, Isaïe secoue la tête.
And the prophet
okay.
Isaiah go, oh my God, what's going on?
Tu as déclaré, je vais voir Ezekias et lui dire que tu lui rajoutes encore 15 années.
And because you have spoken, Lord, Isaiah said, I'm going to go back to speak to King Ezekiah and said, God just added to your life 15 more years.
Vous voyez que nous avons besoin de bouger la main de Dieu parfois.
We need the hand of God sometimes.
Ça prend l'intégrité, la fidélité.
It takes integrity, faithfulness.
Pasteur Nadia, tu as été intègre, tu as été fidèle. Hallelujah.
Pastor Nadia,
que Dieu te bénisse, maman.
Been faithful.
Apôtre, tu as été fidèle et intègre. God bless you.
I've been faithful and fidèle. Hallelujah.
Cross Point à Calgary, vous avez été fidèle et intègre.
Faithful. You've Cross Point, you have been faithful.
Que Dieu vous bénisse.
May the Lord bless you,
Cross Point. Acclamons pour Cross Point.
Just clap your hand for Cross Point.
L'armée du Canada, la police du Canada a été fidèle.
You have been faithful,
agents of God. Vous avez été intègre. Que Dieu vous bénisse.
We celebrate you. May the Lord bless you richly.
Canada a été intègre. Que le Seigneur bénisse ce pays.
Canada be blessed by God again.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Est-ce que nous pouvons nous mettre debout?
Can
c'est
we
la
just
célébration.
Stand up together, all of us.
Et nous allons lever nos voix.
And we will lift up our voices.
Nous allons déclarer sur nous-mêmes l'intégrité et la fidélité.
We will declare the word of God.
Tu vas prophétiser sur ta propre vie.
You are going to prophesy on your own life.
Tu vas dire ma banque au ciel est remplie de fidélité et d'intégrité.
You are going to declare that my account in heaven is full
quel
of
que soit ce qui se passe,
no matter what I'm going through,
quelles que soient les difficultés,
no matter the difficulties,
je marche dans l'intégrité.
I will keep walking in
je
integrity.
Marche dans la fidélité.
I will keep walking in faithfulness.
Et le Seigneur mon Dieu
and so that the Lord, my God,
me répondra lorsque j'en aurai besoin.
Answer to my prayers when I need.
J'intercéderai pour ce peuple, pour ce pays.
I will pray and intercede for this country.
Pour l'église de Dieu.
For the church of God.
Pour ma famille.
For my family.
Pour moi-même.
For myself.
Pour mon ministère.
For my ministry.
Pour mes enfants.
For my children.
Pour ma femme et mon mari.
For my wife and my
pour
husband.
Les ouvriers de l'église.
For the servants in the house.
Pour tous les leaders.
For all the leaders.
Et l'intégrité et la fidélité.
And because the integrity and faithfulness
seront notre partage au nom de Jésus.
Will be our portion in the name
élevons
of
voix,
Jesus.
Élevons nos voix, élevons nos voix.
Lift up your voice and begin to pray together. Thank you, Father.
Oh, Seigneur, notre Dieu, nous bénissons ton nom. Répands, Seigneur, ta grâce encore sur nous.
Spread your grace
nous savons que tu nous as déjà donné cette parole.
Because we know you have already given so much unto us.
L'intégrité et la fidélité.
Integrity and faithfulness.
Et tu nous le rappelles chaque jour.
And you remind us of such every
mais sans toi, nous ne pouvons rien faire.
That without you, we cannot do anything.
Et ce matin, nous te prions encore.
And this morning, we pray unto you.
Fais-nous grâce.
Give us grace and
que la
strength.
Grâce apostolique coule.
Give us the grace. The apostolic grace may cover us.
Couvre ce pays.
May cover this nation.
Couvre la communauté.
May cover the communities.
Bénisse le Canada.
Bless Canada, oh God.
Bénisse toutes les provinces de ce beau
bless
pays.
Bless all the provinces in this country.
Bénisse le peuple du Canada.
Bless the people in Canada.
Bénisse l'église du Canada.
Bless the church in Canada.
Bénisse Cross Point.
Bless Cross Point, oh God.
Bénisse Calgary.
Bless Calgary, oh God.
Bénis la CPVM.
Bless SCPVM.
Bénis
oh
Montréal
Lord.
Et le Québec.
Bless Quebec and Montreal.
Bénis nos familles.
Bless our families, oh God.
Bénis nos enfants.
Bless our children, oh
et
God.
Et bénis ton peuple au nom de Jésus.
And bless your people in the name of Jesus.
On acclame très fort le Seigneur.
Let's give
Dieu
a clap offering to the Lord, Church
bénisse.
Of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. This is for the French speaking, or if you want to practice your French, an amazing book that he wrote about the healing against culpability, guilt, condemnations, and how to reach to receive your forgiveness. It will be outside, and it is $25. Pick up some and be blessed. We have only 13, so run to get some. Can we put our hand together for the men of God? We appreciate you. Amen. We love you so much.
I love you too.
Thank you so much.
I love you.
Thank you, Father. I would like to bring the worship team for one song, and we'll take our envelope to give an offering to the Lord. Amen. And as we come in to give an offering, we dance, because this is Canada Day. It's a celebration day. All right? You can even go grab some of these guys and dance with them a little bit. All right? Let them groove a little bit. Praise the Lord. Are we ready? Are we ready? Worship, are we ready? Thank you, Lord. If you want a machine, they are just in the aisle. You can go and grab an envelope and give to the Lord. I will release it all to the worship team. And when they finish to us, we can be released outside to have a good time. May the Lord bless you, and God love you.
Unto the Lord be the glory.